Proverbs 18:24. Friends can destroy one another, but a loving friend can stay closer than family. And John 15:13. The greatest love you can show is to give your life for your friends. I'm going to be telling about a strong friendship in the Bible, David and Jonathan. But first, Alex Chase. Two bobby pins. This magnet represents friendship, and these bobby pins represent David and Jonathan. Since their friendship is strong, they won't fall off the magnet, and they're close together because they're close together because they'll stick together, and they'll always stay with each other. So, if you have a strong friendship, you'll stay on the magnet, and you'll stay close. There are many scriptures that tells us that a true friend is always loyal. David and Jonathan are perfect pictures of this. As we all know, David killed Goliath. Well, after all of that, Jonathan basically adopted David into his family as a brother, and they became best friends. Eventually, the king became jealous of David and wanted to kill him. This is because King Saul thought God was with David, but not with himself. King Saul had thrown a spear at David. He even told his son and servants that they shall kill David. As a good friend, Jonathan warned David and spoke on his behalf. The king relented by Jonathan telling David their friendship stayed strong and like they didn't fall off the mat. Sometime later, King Saul attempted to kill David again by throwing a spear at him. David knew there was no way he could stay, so he fled. The king went after him. Somehow David made it to Jonathan. He asked his friend why the king was after him and wanted him dead. David said that Jonathan's father would not tell him why because of their friendship. Jonathan did not believe this is true. Jonathan and David made a plan. David was going to skip dinner with the king to be with his family. If the king was okay with it, with him being gone, then everything was fine, and David was not in trouble with the king. But if Jonathan told Saul that David was visiting his family, and the king became angry, then they would know the king wanted David dead. But David worried about Jonathan's safety. He was being a good friend. David thought King Saul would turn on Jonathan as well. As a good friend, you should always make sure they're safe. Your other friend is safe. Jonathan and David made a covenant. And 3 days after Jonathan knew the answer about King Saul and David, he would shoot 3 arrows near a certain rock. If he told his servant boy that the arrows were near, then David was fine and could stay. If Jonathan told the boy that the arrows were beyond, David would have to flee. The first dinner came and all was okay. But at the second dinner, the king asked Jonathan where David was. When he was given the answer, he flew into rage and threw a spear at Jonathan. Jonathan was very angry and saddened by his father. The third day came and Jonathan shot his arrows. He announced to the servant boy that they were beyond. When the boy was sent away, David appeared out of hiding. Jonathan and David hugged and wept. Jonathan told him to remember their covenant before the Lord between them and then sit in heaven. So imagine you have your best friend and you're moving away. I'm pretty sure that you'll miss each other. Well, that's almost like what happened to Jonathan and David. Sometimes people can be like pins. So basically, as I said, this means friendship. The pennies won't stick to the magnet, no matter what you try to do. They aren't meant to be together. They really don't want to be with each other. It's like two people who, they're not new to each other, but they're just not meant to be friends. But maybe they don't really want to just hang out with each other, or they don't have anything in common. You might say hi to them, but you won't tell them a secret or very important information. These people are called acquaintances. Always make sure you know the difference between someone who is a friend and someone who is an acquaintance. Jonathan and David were friends. Yeah. You have to stick to your friends. You need to have a strong friendship with your friends, like David and Jonathan. But even then, you can have friends for a short time or friends that last a lifetime. Like, I met a random Kimberly, and I was about 3 years old, and we are still friends to this day, and we plan to be beautiful. There will be many times when we mess up and treat our friends poorly, or we might be treated poorly by our friends. Perhaps you get into an argument with your friend, or a friend wrongs you in some way. Your friendship is not as strong anymore. When your friendship is strong, you're closer together. And now you're starting to spread apart because your friendship is getting weak. And if neither of you say, I'm sorry, or apologize, or if you don't accept the other person's apology, there will be no more friendship. You could lose your friendship, and that's it. Jonathan and David had a strong friendship. Even though Jonathan did not believe David, their friendship was tight. Once Jonathan knew the truth, he committed treason to save his innocent friend, and take him and let him flee to freedom. He was almost killed by his father because of his friendship with David. We are all like David. We needed to be saved from our sins. But we all had a friend who laid down his life for you and for you so you could go free. Jesus died so you could stand famous before God. This friendship is the strongest one we will ever have. Think about the friends you have. Do you want a strong friendship or a weak friendship? The most loyal friends tell their friends about Jesus. They tell the truth, they accept apologies, they ask for forgiveness. They don't give up on each other. They walk the road of life with each other and with Jesus. So what did you learn from this? If you want to be godly, then you must be a good, loyal friend to others. Even though friends are great, Jesus is the closest best friend we can have.
Amen. Amen.